Hey everybody, Nawaz Modi Singhania here from the Body Art Fitness Centers, going live with you again. This week I have a very interesting guest with a fabulous product. I want to say hi to everyone coming in. I saw Jugnu coming in earlier, Kurshid, Kaushal, so many of you. Akira, hi, Rupal, hi, Yadu. Fantastic, and welcome in. Thanks for joining. So, Salt World is what it is about today. Dipti Babu of Salt World is somebody I met about a month ago when I judged the Times of India Times Unlimited Entrepreneurs Award 2020 Pan India, done beautifully all on Zoom amidst COVID days. So, hi, Pinky, Shibu, Shibani, Esther, Rinka, all you guys, great having you in. I want to get Dipti in right away. So, Dipti started Salt World in 2014. Hi, Dipti, how are you doing? Sorry, we had a little bit of network trouble there.
Yeah. I'm good. How are you?
Very well. Dipti is from Bangalore, guys, and I'm from Mumbai. And Bangalore is a lot safer than Mumbai right now.
COVID. True. But even Bangalore is becoming worse day by day.
Well, what really attracted me, Dipti, to you was the feeling that right now in COVID days, Mother Nature's bounty, which is becoming so apparent. You're seeing so many, these are days which are so dark and terrible and so many awful things are happening out there. But at the same time, my God, you're seeing so much beauty around suddenly. Contrast, you know? So you are seeing also some very beautiful birds and animals coming out and about, and a lot of amazing stuff happening out there within nature as well. Our cities are looking so gorgeous, whereas earlier...
Definitely. And now the weather also has become so nice in Bangalore, and it's raining and it has a very good feeling now.
Raining, hoping our networks hold good. I'm going to say hi to many other people that have come in. Amit, Tanish, Jigesh.
Hi, everyone.
All, thanks for joining. So, you know, salt, when it comes to Mother Nature, I thought, wow, Mother Nature's bounty. Salt is certainly nature's largest gifts to us. And I wanted,
I wanted to
say that we are aware of certain properties of salt. Oh, by the way, before we start, please take a look at my pendant for you. Let me see if you can see it. It is a beautiful seahorse.
Nice.
Yeah, salt and sea. And the sun.
True.
You.
Yeah.
So, considering Mother Nature's bounty, you know, offers so much to us that we sometimes are not even aware of, I wanted to talk about the positive qualities that are known of salt. I mean, we do know that it has fantastic preservative qualities. When you have any sort of, you know, throat infection, etc., it will gargle with salt. Even in these COVID times, you know, very important. It has these antibacterial properties, but it's lesser known for some of the other stuff that I learned from you. It is lesser known, for example, for its properties on the immune system, how it boosts the immune system, the respiratory system, how it affects our skin, the aging process. I'm more interested in this, but of course it offers a lot more too. So could you tell us a little bit more on this front? I know it helps on allergies and a variety of other things. So could you tell us the science behind it?
Sure. So actually salt itself is an antibacterial and antiviral property it has. Okay. It's like even it has an antihistamine in nature. It is an antihistamine in nature. So what happens is when you are inhaling, first of all, I'll tell you what is salt therapy all about. So salt therapy is that you sit in a salt cave. Imagine the snow world. Instead of snow, you will see the salt around. Just for you to imagine, I'm just saying the snow world because most of them would have known about snow, how snow world, how it looks like. So instead of snow, you can see all around the salt. So you sit inside the salt room, and when you are surrounded with the salt, and we use the device called halo generator, which grinds the salt particles and disperses inside the room. What happens is when you're inhaling the salt particles, automatically the whole respiratory system get access to the salt particles. Usually, if you go to the doctor for any kind of nasal congestion, they give the saline spray, nasal spray. Nasal spray is nothing but the saline spray. So why they give that is it breaks the mucus and clears your nasal portion. So that's the reason we use saline solution for gargling purpose, for nasal spray, and even for clearing the like even for the dressing the wound, they use the saline solution to clear the wound before dressing. So for that also they use it. So actually, seeing as you rightly said, it has the property of the preservative property because it kills all the virus and the bacteria around, so automatically it has that preservative quality. So these things we are using like saline spray and saline solution, and if you see the neti pot, we use that salt water in one nostril and take the water in the other nostril and clear the nasal thing. All these things we have used. We have used so many years, like it has been traditionally found in yoga asanas and all these Ayurveda, and even Greek culture has their own native therapies using salt. So what happens is, like now in our therapy, when you are seated inside the salt room, you'll be inhaling the salt particles, which is dry in nature. So it automatically reaches your respiratory system wherever the issue is, like whether it is a lung infection or whether it is asthma, wheezing, everything happens in the lung part, right? So it reaches to that last part called alveoli and clears the whole system. So that's how whatever the mucus or whatever the virus or bacteria is in the respiratory system, it clears the system. So that's how you are putting your
It really gets down all the way to the root of the issue.
So it takes care of the root cause of the issue. So that way the salt therapy helps in clearing the present issue, and even it improves your immune system by reducing the IgE levels. So IgE levels is the reason why you get the allergies. So if the IgE levels is under control, or if it reduces, automatically the allergens will also be reduced in your body. So that is the respiratory allergies also it takes care of. Not only that, even for improving your lung capacity and to clear your even for your skin also it helps because it regulates the pH balance of the skin. And not only that, for people who have the psoriasis, eczema, and all these problems also, it gives you a good relief.
So these irritations get removed and it manages the pH, the acidity level,
Definitely, yeah.
inflammation, and therefore everything is improved. That's what I'm getting from your conversation.
Definitely, definitely.
Right.
Yeah.
Are saying hi, hello to all, and Asad, Sona, Arun, Alisha, Disha, I saw all you guys coming in, Dheeraj, Anu, I saw Salu, Anurag, Yogi made a quick note of people coming in, so I want to say hello to them. So hi all, thank you for joining us. Dipti has some very interesting things to say to us, and I hope you're listening. I'm a little confused, Dipti, about the difference between your regular salt treatment and your flotation therapy. Could you explain?
So we have the salt room therapy. That is what that I explained to you about it. This is otherwise called as halotherapy, and this is originated from the Eastern Europe. So there used to be the natural salt caves, and from that it has come up. It is evolution. The evolution is from the origin is from the salt caves. And the other one which I'm in, like which we are into, is the Dead Sea concept. That is the flotation therapy, where you can directly go to the Jordan and experience the Dead Sea effect. Like just lie down on the surface of the water and you'll be floating. And what we have done it in Bangalore and in our place is the same thing, mimicking the original Dead Sea concept by adding 1,000 liters of water plus 850 kgs of Epsom salt to get that density of the water, and it keeps you with the buoyancy of the water, it keeps you floating. So when you float, automatically you will be landing to your the mind goes directly to your the alpha state and theta state, and keeps your mind detox. Basically, it's a mind detox and a meditation in a deeper way, if you say. See, meditation is all about inhale, like you'll be concentrating on your own breath, right? The same thing happens when you're floating. You'll be able to hear only your breath and nothing else. And that takes you to the different level, like theta stage, and keeps your mind detox. And even the way that you tackle things will be different because your mind is clear. So that is about the mind detox. And other part is, like, even if you have any body pains, this Epsom salt solution will drag out the pain from your body, because Epsom salt is nothing but the magnesium sulfate. So it is a magnesium sulfate which gets into your body through reverse osmosis method and takes out all the pain in your body and keeps your magnesium level also in good content. Because nowadays magnesium, there are a lot of people who doesn't have a sufficient magnesium in our body. So because even the ground does not have the sufficient magnesium where we get the food from. So this is another alternative way to improve your magnesium levels.
That's very fascinating, which actually is making me wonder that when it comes to salt in this capacity, obviously it has a huge property of affecting cells. There's a very huge connection between salt, the amount of salt in cells, the amount of water that's retained, and if it affects us so deeply, as you explained, on the alpha, theta, so on, so level, and it makes us calmer, it affects our mind, etc. It obviously has a, and we're made of more than 75% water. So obviously, it impacts us, therefore, on a very, very deep level in other ways as well.
So usually for the salt room therapy, which where we use the sodium chloride, pure sea salt is will be around in the salt room, and when you are inhaling the salt particles, it is 100% pure NaCl. So that is nothing but the sodium chloride. Automatically, the way that you asked is that the water retention, right? So when you are inhaling the salt particles,
See, that
can
question was water retention. The question was that every cell in its composition has certain ions and certain salts and a certain amount of hydration, etc. So this cell hugely, and with bodies being 75% water, there would be a very huge impact on that. That impacts our mind, our psyche, our even our nature and things.
Definitely, definitely. So, salt is actually a boon for us. Like, even if you're thinking about, like, if you're even after the therapy or before the therapy, we ask the person to drink a lot of water before, or like just double the quantity of drinking water when you are taking the therapy. Means if you are taking some 3 liters of water, just try to take it around 4.5 liters of water per day. So that helps you to keep hydrated.
Correct, correct. Which leads me to your next question. So sorry, so I've understood that the salts that are primarily used are Epsom salts, magnesium sulfate, sodium chloride, right?
So sodium chloride is for the inhaling purpose, and for the other therapy called flotation therapy, we use the Epsom salt, that is magnesium sulfate.
Super. Many more entrants are saying hello and sending us hearts and love and appreciating what we're doing. We've got Ranjit, Danish, Amit, Purva, Shahid, Ritika.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for listening to me.
Aparna, Aparna, Aparna. Vicky, Harsha, Akash, Bhavna, Ranjit, hi everyone, and thanks for joining us. Okay, so please tell me, Dipti, how did you actually get into this? It's you must have had some very interesting journey or story back there to tell. What's your bigger connect?
Sure. So actually, I don't know how I got into this because there's some connection. Even when I was very young, I gave a speech about sodium chloride. I don't know why I gave the speech about sodium chloride when I was in sixth standard. And after that, I did not have any touch about means. I did not think about salt at all. But when I was working after my I did my MBAs. And after my MBA, I started working in many companies like JK White Cement and Dulux Paint. Yeah.
Okay.
So I worked in the project sales where I go meet many construction. I see many constructions and I feel like so many constructions everywhere. And people will be affected with their respiratory system is what I keep thinking about it, but I at that time also I didn't know that I'll be landed with in this industry. But when I was searching for, I had a very hungry of starting something on my own. So that's how what happened is.
Sometimes we just fall into something and we're not sure why, but there are guiding lines, and. I guess one has to thank your chemistry teacher, right, for mistaken
chemistry. Yeah, chemistry was the I was very weak in chemistry at that time, but now I am more into it.
I'm delighted to see Rageshwari. Hi, hi, hi. Thank you for joining us. I'm delighted to see Seema. I'm not so delighted not to see Atul. Where is he? And Dharmesh, Deepak, Akash, Rajesh, I'm seeing so many others. So hi, thank you for joining in. And let's continue with this. So, you know, there are a few, well, I don't know if they're myths or they're facts around this. Maybe you can clear it up for us. But it is kind of said that, you know, when it comes to salt, salt increases the blood pressure and one should reduce their salt intake. What is your that one?
So actually salt, if you see, our ancestors were using the salt from and that too, you know that Indian cuisines are made up of like a lot of salty and salt, and all the tastes will be in a higher mode only. It will not be in the very lighter version. It will be with higher thing only. But still, they did not get the BP and all these things. It's a lifestyle disease which has evolved very recently. So those days when they were using it, there was no other additional additives in it. It was just the pure sea salt which is there. They just take it and just clean it. Obviously, they just have a they just take out the dust particles in it and start using it. It was nice. And later on, when they started adding on a lot of chemicals into it, and that too, not only that, is the reason that there is another reason that we started getting into the outside food, like junk and things like that. So the intake of salt has been doubled. When you have a pizza or burger, you don't know how much salt is there inside that. But when you are having the home food, you know how much salt is getting into the food. So usually the quantity of everyday intake also matters. So that's how anything that is more is bad to the health. But when you are, when we are having home food in a very good manner, automatically our salt intake will be taken care of.
Yes. So it's quality, it's quantity. And what Dipti is telling us is not to throw the baby away with the bath water. There's a lot of...
So actually salt has become the culprit. It is actually victim. It is victim now.
Makes a lot of sense. Our bodies are not free of salt. Our world is not free of salt. There is
yeah.
nothing that is free of salt. It has a very, very important purpose.
Yeah.
Yes,
Check
absolutely.
anything, it has salt, whether you sweat or tears or whether, even if you take a vegetable or fruit, there is a particular amount of sodium chloride is there in each and every food. Nature has given sodium chloride in everything because it is required for our body, because salt is something which helps nutrition to travel from one cell to another cell. The transit from one cell to another cell of nutrition and this thing, energy, it is through the salt only. So without salt, no human being or no animals or no living beings can survive, I can say.
Thank you for clearing that up and yes, putting things in perspective. Chetan, delighted to see you. I'm sure Yogi is there somewhere in the background. Maria and Krish, if you're there, hi. And also very pleased to see Aran and the rest. Okay, so Aparna is asking a very important question, which is that what is the best salt that one should use for home cooking?
So as of now, the pink Himalayan pink salt can be used for the home purpose, for cooking purpose, because there is no much things has been added in it. So it is just the natural source of the salt which has been available now. So the normal table salt, you have lot many things like bleaching agent or anti-caking agent, the adis and all. But when you see the Himalayan pink salt, it is actually naturally sourced, so you can use it. But again, I could see there are many other companies which have the salt with the color. So when you're washing some vegetables with the salt, you can see the color coming out from the salt. So that's not the right salt. So you can actually check it out while buying.
Right. So when it comes to the Himalayan pink salt, is there a particular brand that you recommend?
So actually, we also sell Himalayan pink salt directly procured from the origin. It is from the Kebra mines and near to the Himalayan region. So from there it has so the only source of pink salt, Himalayan pink salt, is from the Kebra caves. So from there we have an importer who is
Is that
Kebra mines.
Evra Mines?
Yeah.
How do you spell that?
Khewra.
Khewra. There has to be
Yeah.
a way for us Mumbaiites and others to source it, no?
So actually it is in the Pakistan.
Ah.
So it's in Pakistan, like some 300 or 400 miles away from Himalayan region, but it comes under Himalayan region also, some
Let's not get into all those questions.
places. Sure.
Let's see where we are. So yeah, salt I'm being asked by somebody, is that good for our health? Somebody is posing that question. I didn't know there was a
Which one?
Tata tea salt. Is that what you said? I just saw that go by. Whoever asked that question, do post it again. I'm wondering if I saw it correctly. Hi, Deepika. Hi, Deepak. Hi, everyone. Okay, so the other question is that another doubt, edema, bloating, when that happens and we feel a bit larger, we're told to reduce our salt intake. I'm assuming that you've kind of already answered that question when you spoke about the quality and the quantity, right? It's probably.
Yeah, and that too, in our therapies, the salt which has been used is just been inhaled. It has not been consumed by it doesn't get into the digestive tract. You'll be inhaling it and reaches only the respiratory system.
Ah.
So it doesn't come under that daily consumption of salt and that and this and all, because it goes only to the respiratory system.
Right, so
It
that's
doesn't enter your,
important thing out here
yeah.
too. Yeah,
And
okay.
also it helps the salt salt helps in de-stressing also. So de-stressing, depression, for all these things salt helps, because the negative ions which is in the salt will be very effective for stress and depression and having a good soothing mind. So BP also can be controlled if it is because of the mind.
Right.
So if
Thank
you
you.
are having BP because you are having a lot of junk, I cannot help it. You can reduce in the The nutrition can the nutritionist can help you.
Absolutely, yeah. So Tata, I'm told, does have a Himalayan pink salt. Seema, my friend, is saying. Is that right?
Yeah, there are many companies which have the pink salt, so you can have a check on it.
Right. And being a good reputed company,
And
it gives some.
yeah,
Yeah.
so we also have we also deal with the products like Himalayan pink salt and salt clamps. And salt clamps gives you a pleasant feeling when it is with you, like your stress levels and everything will be lesser when the reddish orange colored light you are looking at it, according to the color therapy also. When you are looking at that kind of color for longer period, your mind will be out of stress. That is the reason Himalayan pink salt can be used at home for having a good relaxed time.
I think Seema, that answers your question of how it helps. Which salt do I use in my kitchen? Somebody's asking me. Oh God, I wish I could answer that question. I actually have the skill of even burning water. I'm very good with telling my chefs how to make things, but they make it to perfection then when I instruct them, but I can't actually do it myself, strangers. So I can't really answer you on that one. I'm sorry, but it is going to now be Himalayan pink salt. I promise you, probably a dozen. Okay. Hey, Prerna, Dylan, Abdullah, Sachdev, hi all, and you're most welcome, Seema. And now the last thing for you out here is, could you give us some interesting salt-based recipe or two which helps us these days increase the immune system in COVID times?
Yeah, actually, what we used to give for the people who come for us for the flotation therapy is just a mint, lime, and a little of pink salt, and a little of ginger with honey. It's a drink where it keeps you refreshing, as well as ginger, as everyone knows that it helps in immune system, immunity also. So that's the reason we give this for as a refreshing drink after the flotation session. So this is what we also use it at home to boost up our immune system, or to keep our immune system in good way, so in a better way.
Yeah. So, that's very easy, guys. Did you hear the recipe? Again, mint or all immunity, very easy to make, refreshing. She said, Dipti said, mint and pink salt, lime, ginger, and honey. Did I miss anything else?
Nothing else. So what we do is this, but usually our traditional food itself has a lot of like turmeric or ginger, or most of the herbs that we use are the one that it gives a good immune system. In case if you want to do everything at home, the quality will be better. If you are buying the everything like ginger garlic paste and everything at from outside, then you cannot assure the quality. So that's the only thing.
Absolutely. Very useful. There are, of course, you guys, you know that there are many spices, herbs, even fruits, vegetables hugely increase the
Yeah,
immune. Many
definitely.
spices and herbs that help. Some which Dipti has mentioned right now, some which she hasn't. Ginger, garlic, onions, chilies, black pepper, specific
Yeah.
vegetables like broccoli, spinach, kale. I sometimes make dishes of only these immune boosters, so that everybody in the family has to have it, whether they want to or they don't. So there we are. One more question from Seema. Is warm water, or is it warm water or regular water, specific time of day to be consumed?
So we can opt for warm water. Lukewarm water is always good for your body. Instead of regular water, you can opt for lukewarm water. And even early in the morning, gargling with salt water also gives you a good. Because nowadays, every doctor recommends that as well. Like you just gargle with salt water to keep your system clean.
Days, yeah, especially these days with the yes,
Yeah.
vocal cords, Absolutely. And you must remember, Seema, that Dipti is joining us from the south. She's joining us from Bangalore. So there is a bit of a, there is that Ayurvedic influence as well. So yes,
Sure.
thank you so much, Dipti. It's been such a pleasure. Thank you for clearing all this out. Karan, Jatin, hi, all you guys. Sapna, hi. Sorry, the question was meant your concoction. In which water? Sorry, she was asking this concoction of yours would be in which water? Regular water, the mint, the ginger honey, etc.
So normal water, once you started adding lemon in it, automatically the water gets into the alkaline this thing. So you are drinking a good water, so healthy water.
Or should be regular at room temperature, or what is the question?
Which one? Which one? The drink, is it? It's up to you. However you wanna you wanna drink it.
All right, so Seema, enjoy. Ice cube in and up maybe. All right, so anything up and helping us during these times. It was fabulous. And yes, we'll be in touch with you. Thank you, all you guys, for joining us. And see you next
Thanks
time.
a lot. Thanks a lot for you and the people around who are watching it. Thanks a lot.
And see you guys next Sunday. Very interesting topic again. I will put out more information on what it is soon enough. Watch this space. Take care. All the best. See you.
Sure. Thank
Bye.
you. Bye. Bye.